What's going on, you fuckers? It's Gromit. And, I was getting bored. And I'm sick. So I've decided I'm going to make a video. And because I'm sick and bored, I'm not going to make anything too physically or mentally draining. So this goes out to all my OG Doctor Who fans that subscribed to this channel back when I used to make Doctor Who related content when I was a squeaky 12-year-old. Today I'm going to be going over my entire Doctor Who VHS collection. Now, I want to give some context into why I've got all these Doctor Who VHSs. I personally prefer, with Classic Who, VHS to DVD, because with VHS, they're unmastered. You don't get all that fucking digitally remastered shit. And I think it gives a more realistic feeling to how the story was originally meant, well, not meant to be viewed, but originally was viewed. Of course, that I'm not including Blu-rays in this, because Blu-rays, I'd pick a Blu-ray any day over a VHS, of course. But I think when it comes to standard definition Doctor Who, the VHS is the way to go forward. So I've only been collecting Doctor Who VHSs for about 2 weeks. And recently I've got rid of most of my Doctor Who DVD collection, so these are much cheaper, and like I said, they are much more, they're much more fun to watch. So we'll get straight into it with an unearthly child here at the front. Yeah, it's great. Great long story. Episode 1's of course a masterpiece, and I think many people are too quick to judge episode 2, 3 and 4 as being shit. But to be honest, I quite like it, you know, like my father found fire, blah, 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 blah. You know what I mean? It's a good little story. You should give it a watch all the way through. And yeah. Next we've got The Keys of Marinos, which is, it's a cool concept for a story, of course. It's almost like six mini stories in one main story, but it does get boring after a while, to be honest. Next we got the Aztecs, which there is no competition, there's no saying that needs to be said. It's a great story, check it out. Next we got the Hartnell box, which contains the Sensorites, the Time Meddler and the Gunfighters. And just for an extra little thing, these tapes are actually still sealed, as you can see. Just obviously cool, you know, something that hasn't been opened since 2002. Pretty awesome. Then we got another copy of the Gunfighters here, that one is opened. And then we got my favourite Hartnell story, which is the War Machines. This is an absolutely fantastic Earthbound story. Seems very, very real for the time period of which this was recorded, 1966, when technology really was starting to develop at an insane rate, we should say. But yeah, this is an absolutely fantastic story, and I'd advise anyone to watch it. Fuck's sake. Now we go on to my favourite Doctor, Patrick Troughton, with Tomb of the Cybermen, which, if you haven't watched, what are you doing? Then we've got the Mind Robber, and this is the first of these blue and black cases. These are UK Gold, or like BBC Two repeats. This one has the Mind Robber and the Sea Devils on it, which was recorded off BBC Two in the year 1992, I believe. So yeah, the Mind Robber. Next we got the Dominators, which is my least favourite Patrick Troughton story, but it's still a Patrick Troughton story, and Patrick Troughton doesn't have a bad, like, acting performance throughout his entire tenure. Then we've got the Crotons, which gets too much unnecessary hate. I do really like this story. It's just fun. It's a fun little story. Give it a watch. Next we've got the Seeds of Death, which is the last good Base Under Siege story until we get to probably the Tom Baker era. Probably not until like Ark and Space do we have an actually good Base Under Siege story again. Could blame that mainly because fucking 8/10 of John Pertwee's era was all set on Earth, but yeah, Seeds of Death, it's a good story. It's not my favourite Patrick Troughton story, but it is a good story. And then we got at the end here, The War Games, which is all recorded on one tape. But unfortunately, it is just recorded from the VHS rip, so it is a second generation copy, which doesn't look as good, but you know, it's the entire War Games on one tape. And yeah, this is a fantastic story, of course. Next, we got the Spearhead from Space, Spearhead from Space. Don't know why I added the at the start. We start season 7, possibly one of the best Doctor Who seasons of all time. And with a banger, Spirit from Space, I give this a 9 out of 10 every day of the week. It's not as good as the story that follows it though, which is Doctor Who and the Silurians, which is an absolutely fantastic story. 10 out of 10 every day of the week. The Silurians are such a great, well, not even necessarily villains. I know that the One Controller is technically the villain of this story because he wants to take over the Earth so much, but it's the first of those John Pertwee stories where, you know, there's a sense of good in the aliens in the story, but it just comes down to, much like the humans are, who don't want the Silurians on their planet, the Silurians don't want the humans on their planet. And the Doctor tries and fucking sorts a peace treaty, but of course, the Brigadier is a military mind and blows all the fucking Silurians up. 10 out of 10 every day of the week. Then we've got Terror of the Autons, the first Roger Delgado master story, and it's a great story. The return of the Nestine consciousness in this, and yeah, it's just a fantastic story. A bit dark as well. Then we've got Day of the Daleks. This has a lot of stories on it. This has Day of the Daleks, The Mind Robber, The Mind of Evil, which is probably my favourite out of all these four, and then The Android Invasion. Day of the Daleks, which is the case I decided to give for it because it was difficult finding a case that would work for Mind of Evil. Ah! I'll put it away later. Fucking hell. Then we got the Sea Devils. Which is just another BBC Two repeat. And then we move on to Robot, which is a great Tom Baker story. I do know that this is very much just a Pertwee story with Tom Baker in it, but it's still a Pertwee story with Tom Baker in it. What could possibly be bad about it? Yeah, I'm going to take this away and close that up later. Then we've got The Ark in Space, which is the first good base under siege story, I believe, since The Seeds of Death. And yeah, this is a great story for a six-parter. It does kind of drag on a bit, especially, you know, six-parters that are base under siege, where there's not a lot of, you know, it's base under siege stories are very much about the atmosphere, instead of, you know, the Doctor running around with some companions in various different places, because it is all set on a few sets. Then we got the Centauran Experiment in Genesis of the Daleks in a two-tape set. Centauran Experiment is a good little story. If you just want to sit down, you've got 40 minutes spare, and you want to watch a classic Who story, there's nothing wrong with the Centauran Experiment. And then Genesis of the Daleks needs no introduction. It is one of the greatest Doctor Who stories of all time. Then we got Terror of the Zygons, which is a good story. The start of season 13, the last appearance of Harry Sullivan, as played by Ian Marta. Yeah, I can't remember much about this story, to be honest. I know that it is very much loved, but I don't think it's one of the greatest Tom Baker stories. Then we got Planet of Evil, which is near. Pyramids of Mars, which is certainly the best from season 13. What a story this is. Sutek, probably one of the best one-off Doctor Who villains of all time, apart from, what's his name, in the Caves of Androzani? Mars or Ken or something? I don't know. The Android Invasion, again, an underrated story. I do quite like this one. Just that feeling of, I don't know, to be honest, it's just kind of how you don't know who's real and who isn't real, if you know what I mean. Then we got The Brains of Morbius, which is a bit of an overrated story. It's still good though, it's still good. The Mask of Mandragora. and Sarah Jane's Last The Hand of Fear, which is, of course, a classic story. If you go on a Sarah Jane binge, you'll get to the story, and I'd be surprised if you don't cry at the end of episode 4. Then we've got The Deadly Assassin, which is a great return for the Master, and a fantastic four-parter set on Gallifrey and The Matrix. And again, like The Mind Robber and like Android Invasion, like I said before, it's that illusion that something is real, but it's not real at the same time. I just love Doctor Who stories that do that, and The Deadly Assassin is definitely not an exemption from that list. Then we've got The Talons of Weng Chiang here, starring Tom Baker as the Doctor. It's a bit too long. I know it's a great story still, but I feel like it could have been four parts. And then we got my favourite Tom Baker story, The Horror Fang Rock. Probably the most underrated Doctor Who story of all time. This is a masterpiece, so dark. The atmosphere in the story is just fucking electrifying from start to finish. You know, like when the Doctor says, like, just like wittily laughs out, like, "Oh, this lighthouse is under attack, and by morning we might all be dead." It's just an absolutely classic story, 10 out of 10 all the way. Then we've got The Invasion of Time, which again is a great story. I know this gets a bit of hate, especially, I do agree that it is a fucking shit send-off for Leela. But I do like how episodes 1 to 3, much like The Ark with William Hartnell, episodes 1 to 3 is a Gallifrey story, and then it turns into a Centauran story very quickly. Now we move on to the Key to Time era, which have these awesome VHS spines. I'm going to try and collect all of these, even though season 16 isn't really my favourite Doctor Who season at all. We've got The Stone's Blood, which is my second favourite, just behind the Armageddon Factor. Oh, look, it's The Keeper of Troc, and this is a good story from season 18. Season 18 is a good fucking Doctor Who season, no matter what anyone says. I think the East Space trilogy, apart from maybe Full Circle, which is a bit naff. And then Keeper of Troc and Legopolis, which is my favourite from season 18, are both great stories. I know, I do agree that this isn't the best send-off for the, what in most people's eyes is the best Doctor of all time. But, you know, it's still a good story, and that's all it comes down to, really. Now we go on to the Peter Davison era. Fucking runny nose everywhere. Kinder. Yeah, it's a bit boring, to be honest. I prefer Snake Dance. Then we've got The Ark of Infinity, which is a great Doctor Who story. Just love the scenes in Amsterdam. And, you know, I think it's definitely underrated. I understand why people think it's boring, because it is kind of, I don't know, nothing really happens in it, to be honest. It's very much based around just Omega transferring into the Doctor, and nothing really much else significant. But it's a good story, like I said. I still enjoyed it. Then we got Terminus, which, to be honest, I've never watched. Then we've got Attack of the Cybermen. This also has the Twin Dilemma on it. These are UK Gold repeats. Twin Dilemma is, it's terrible, but it's still fun to watch, I guess. And Attack of the Cybermen, it's a good Cybermen story. It's not as good as Earthshock. Not as bad as Silver Nemesis. It's a good story. Then we've got Vengeance on Varos, which is, of course, my favourite Colin Baker story, like everyone else in the fucking world is. Yeah, it's a great Doctor Who story, you know. You wouldn't see any TV presented much like this today, you know, because it very much is just a message saying how corrupt the UK government was at this time under Margaret Thatcher. And then the only Sylvester McCoy story I have on VHS is The Curse of Fenric, which is a bit confusing, but it's still a great story to watch. So that's the end of Classic Who. And now we've got the TV movie, which is absolutely fantastic. I love the TV movie, and I watched it yesterday. And this is an original BBC One recording of the TV movie from the 26th of May 1996. And I'll show you what I mean by that now.
So as you see, like, when I start the story,
There is like the genuine BBC one fucking ident. So yeah, it's you know, again, people say, oh, this is fucking dreadful, I hate the TV movie, because, you know, like, Eric Roberts, he overacts and he camps up the masters to the fucking extremes, and like, you know what I mean, it's just, it's all Americanized, but it's a good movie, you know what I mean, stop fucking hating on it. That's the end of Doctor Who, now we're on to miscellaneous stuff. We've got more than 30 years in the TARDIS, which is my favourite Doctor Who documentary of all time. Then we've got the Hartnell years, this also has the Dalek, the early years on it. Very much, these are just kind of like the BBC Enterprises way of getting out what remained of missing Doctor Who stories at the time. So this has like the original Unearthly Child on it, but it also has like episodes of The Crusade, The Celestial Toymaker, for the Daleks' early years. You know, you've got two episodes of the Daleks, you've got two episodes of the Daleks' Master Plan and Evil of the Daleks. No, it's very much like the beginnings of what would become the Lost in Time box set. And then here at the end we've got the two Peter Cushing movies, Doctor Who and the Daleks, and the Daleks' Invasion of Earth, 2150. Both fantastic movies. Both you should watch. So there we go, people. That was my Doctor Who VHS collection as of 2020. I'll probably be doing one next year, unless I've just decided to put YouTube by then, because this collection is going to grow significantly. Thank you for watching. This has been Gromit, and I'll see you fucking later, my niggas.